Okay, it's April 18th. It's 10:18 a.m. right now. I've got two tomatillos that were growing in the house. I want to get these out here, and the camera is on the tripod, which is broke as it is. So I'm holding it, trying to do the best I can to videotape this stuff. Those were put down yesterday, and they're looking fairly decent. It's going to rain today. I've got torch sunflowers. I planted all along this edge, but I only see about five or six of them. Right there is one, the big green leaves. Right there is one. There's another one. And here's where a bunch of them are together. Just sprinkle them down there, up to here, and then we have our walkway. It's got grass on it, but we're not worried about that right now. Anyway, yesterday there were eight okra plants growing. Eight. Today we counted 28, 10 more, because we have okra. Two plants are coming up at one time, because they tell you to plant two or three seeds in one, which I don't like, because you have to thin it out. And I plant them into the garden. I don't put them in pots and then put them out here. There's two there, one there, there, none, okay, none. And you got two right there, two right there. Now these are burgundy okra in the middle two rows, and the outside is spineless green okra, and I even put some just dark green pot okra in the last row there, of which this one there is growing. That should be a spineless green okra, red okra, burgundy okra, two burgundy okra, two burgundy okra, burgundy okra. The first row I didn't have any okra growing. Oh, there's stuff in the front one, perhaps, maybe, but got burgundy okra there. Looks like possibly two burgundy okra in there. That one on the left there coming out, maybe. Burgundy okra. Burgundy okra. Burgundy okra. Okay. Last row. You see the spineless or green, long pod green. I just went out here and planted more seeds on top of what was out here. Like I have in the past, I get them all mixed. But they're heirloom, I don't care about anything else. Now the cantonella bean, which is an Italian bean, that one's not growing right there. That one right there is growing. It's about 3 inches above the ground. So you got one, two, three, four, five, six. What was he? Seven and eight. Where is that? Right there, eight. Now, of all these, there's only two holes that look like nothing. Although I think there was one in that one down there. I put some soil on top, though. I think that's where it is. It's covered, but it's coming up. So there's nine out of 10 growing right now in this. I put these little makeshift things, let me zoom out. Those green fencing things, like right here, there's like eight of them together, and I broke them into pieces of two. So I got one, two, three, four, five in this first row, and I got five in the next row. And then I took one of these, or two of these, and I broke them apart and made singles over there for another beam, for the same beam. And I'm gonna step through these, be careful with the string, with my knee. I'm gonna end up falling down out here. I'll be laying out here for a while crying. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Okay, now on this second set here, I think I only planted about two or four. I planted four here, but there's nothing coming up on this yet. That one right there. Right there. See, with this crack, I might be right on it, but I have to keep moving the camera so I can see it underneath the crack. There's one. And then there's two at the back here. This is the north end of the garden. And where's that at? Right there, the triangle, like the square. It looks like one growing there, but I'm not positive yet. I haven't got down there to look at it. But here I have cucumbers. Again, now everything is heirloom, so it's not the crap you buy at China Mart. Menards, I don't even know what their stuff's like anymore. Some of these other places, Home Depot. Probably, generally, they buy the cheapest stuff they can get to make the biggest profit, so that's what's going to answer your questions for a lot of stuff. Heirloom Solutions, because I bought something of great value, gave me a free thing for 10 years, $100 a year for 10 years. And I have more than enough seeds from the first year. And now this is the third year I bought seeds. And I bought seeds, yeah, I used the gift certificate. But anyway, let's go off on that. There's a cucumber growing there. Now I've seen two cucumbers growing right down there. One down there, I can see it with my naked eye. Cucumber growing right there and there. One growing here. Here's one, another one I covered up a little bit this morning. It's already pushed up in about an hour and a half's time. It's pushed that up a little bit. And then there's this, I don't think it's cucumber. That might be a weed. Well, there's a cucumber growing at the bottom part. And then that top thing, I believe, is a weed. We're going to pull that out. See, you got time to do that too now. You don't have to look through all the grass that we had out here before in the garden. Our garden basically looked like that right there with stuff in it. But now we've got all this plastic down, which is making a major dent, killing off all the plastic. Next year we may not use the plastic. So this is Italian continent, catena bean, whatever it's called. Nothing in these two. That's the one over there I was showing you where there was like 8 out or 9 out of 10 there. But out of this one here, we got two there, nothing growing. Nothing growing there, there's one here. Okay. We have enough of that, I believe. We just planted four more sections of broccoli right here. Put in 3-4 seeds of it. It's a heirloom seed also. I just kind of got onto where I could use the original soil, which is like a clay sand mix almost, to seal around the plastic, which I should have done with all the plants. But you learn as you go, at least I am. And then there's my original four broccoli in the back there. Again, I can't see if it's on here. I think the back four spaces are broccoli right on the corner there. Anyway, so in the middle here, I have two cantaloupe I planted. I'm gonna raise this up now. Make it easier to do this too, because I don't have any type of hat on my head or a do-rag or anything else. My hair is getting in my eyes, so got the front two up there is cantaloupe honeydew melons. Again, with the crack, I can't see. I think it right there, those two in the middle. Then we got a Jubilee watermelon, sugar baby watermelon. Sugar baby watermelon and Jubilee watermelon planted seed, one seed each. And a lot of people, they'll sprinkle two or three seeds in a hole, which is what they suggest because a lot of their seeds are crap. This stuff, I planted one seed, one plant has grown on everything I've ever gotten from Heirloom Solutions, everything. So these are quality seeds, Heirloom Solutions, you know. They're still, even though I got the $100 a year for 10 years, they're like $5 for people that don't buy anything or just buy straight from them. Mine are like $4.75 or $4.25 if I buy one packet extra. So, but anyway, I get more than enough, so I don't even buy more. I should do buy a couple here and there just to help support them. These are all black zucchinis. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There's 10 in this first, this one more right here. And of the 10, 9 are growing. Because one of them I buried, but it's growing, and I put soil on top, pine soil. But that one right there, that might be a golden zucchini. Black beauty in that first hole. Again, with this black, with this mark across the lens, I can't really see. I'm hoping I'm getting it all. I'm trying to move it around so I get it down there for you to see it. See right there, if I can. That's black zucchini, black beauty zucchini right there. I put holes with the hole digger before, and I said I'd rather do the X's. There's one right there. That should be golden zucchini. This one here I buried. No, that one there I buried. There's a little golden zucchini in there underneath that hole. This should be a black beauty. This one here I started burying. It's already coming up too. That's a black beauty zucchini. Golden zucchini. Black beauty zucchini. Black beauty zucchini. There's two there. I'm gonna have to destroy one of them. I hate doing that even. God, that's why I usually try just doing one seed, but I put down the second seed. I don't know why, unless it fell out in there. This is a golden zucchini. What's that right there? This is a purple hull pea. This came out of my mom's garden. You can't hardly find purple hull peas. You can get purple hull beans, but not purple hull peas. These are purple hull peas. There's two growing there. I'm gonna try like hell to save both of those. And I planted three more over here, right in the first row. Purple hull pea, purple hull pea, and purple hull pea. But none of those are, I don't see growing yet. I mean, they might if I look really good, but over here I got black-eyed peas now. Nothing growing out of that one yet. This one here was a plant that was in the house. It died, but I planted a black-eyed pea behind it about 3 days ago, 2 days ago. Planted one there. This one was in the house, it's dying, but I planted another one in there also. These I planted directly out here. Yeah, one right there, black-eyed pea. Black-eyed pea. Black-eyed pea. See, that one's coming back to life. That one was in the house, it started dying out. But see how that one's coming back? And that one right there is a black-eyed pea that we planted out here. And here we've got broccoli. Different strain of heirloom broccoli. There's two or three seeds in that hole, in that hole, that one, and that one. So that's the garden. I got sunflowers all around the edges here. Don't look like much, but when it all starts coming up, it's gonna look so nice. And like I always ask everybody that's watching this that kind of laughs about it or makes any kind of excuse or fun about it, excuse is the main thing. What if you got planted? And if you got more planted, that's great. I'm happy. I mean, but people need to start doing something. If you have to plant anything, plant a tomato plant and a pepper plant even. Those are the easiest ones to grow. They're growing in the house right now. We got all types of heirloom seeds. I mean, just different names. It's unreal. But they're growing in the house. And that's what the front two gardens are going to be for. That's number two, the one right there. That's number two garden. I can't see this good with the crack, but number one, it's like number one, where those tomatillos are at, it's going to have peppers and tomatoes. And of course, man, God's making the wind blow out here. And then the one off to the left there, that's number two garden. And this big one, this big garden back here is number three garden. So, and I'm slowly getting everything set up too. I got potting soil and garden mixed together. I can't see in here. And that round body right there with lime mixed in it. And then that's my mulch, my compost and everything. Table scraps. Pine mulch, everything's gonna go in there and sit in there probably till next season. I just got a black piece of this plastic on top blocking it for the wind and the rain, and let it get hot, and I come out here every 2 days and stir it, and bring in the eggshells and stuff like that, coffee filters, coffee, tea. So again, you gotta do something. You know, it's like they always say, you gotta believe in someone, you'll fall for anything. If you trust in the government, you're really stupid. I'm sorry to say it. Well, I'm not sorry. I'm going to make it a point to say that because, you know, so many people are basically just lazy. I'll just go to Walmart and buy it there, you know. That's the place to buy stuff in China that's been proven, and not once or twice, but I'd say hundreds of times, to sell stuff that's tainted. But you want to trust your family to that type of food? That's your choice. It won't be your choice much longer. You're going to be told what you can eat and what you can't eat, and where you can live and where you can't live, and what you can wear and what you can't wear, what you can watch and what you can't watch. Oh, they're doing that part already. Stop watching the fucking idiot box.